Peliatan, just to the south of Ubud, is an important center for dance. Nowhere else in Bali is so much energy concentrated on this form of expression. In addition to performing the traditional religious dances, dancers from Peliatan interpret the art form for visitors. Balinese dance, drama, and music blend in a rich unity and flavor the entire experience of life with an artistic and creative grace. Magic exists in the relationship between the dancer and the musicians. They cooperate to entertain the gods, and the seriousness of this undertaking inspires a level of performance seldom achieved elsewhere. Each musical accent is reflected by and personified in the movement of the dancer. These movements are, in fact, a highly refined language with strictly defined grammar and rules. The positions and movements of each body element are named and defined. For the movements of feet and legs, there are 30 names. For those of the arms, 16 names. For hands and fingers, 19 names. For the trunk, 14. For neck and shoulder movements, 20 names, and for facial expressions, at least 16. Each term defines a specific element of a rich and expressive language through which musician and dancer make visible the drama they are performing. The orchestra, known as a gamelan, is often said to lead the dancers, but then the most skilled dancers are said to lead the musicians. What is apparent is the harmony between them. The legong is the most famous, demanding, and feminine of the Bali dance styles. Performers are young girls, usually preteen, who begin their training at a tender age. It's during early youth that suppleness and devoted attention are great enough to master these difficult forms. By their mid-teens, these legong dancers will be forced into retirement, perhaps to teach the next generation or to participate in other dance forms. The movements of the dancers are highly stylized, as are the movements of the wayang kulit puppets, and leave the casual visitor bewildered. To the Balinese, however, they are as familiar as I Love Lucy and have been rerun for far longer. An important element of Balinese dance is the ceremonial mask, a window into the world of the spirit portrayed by the dancer. The topeng dance is an important form of entertainment as well as ritual for temple ceremonies. Tales of kings and warriors from Bali's history are enacted, sometimes serious, other times slapstick, earthy, and humorous. Older men usually act in the topeng. Sometimes one man plays all the characters, changing masks with each role. In preparation for this dance, the topeng enacts an ancient ritual. In a small booth to the rear of the dance area, the artist readies himself with prayer. When the dance is to begin, the dancer ceases his meditation and carefully dons the mask. His preparations have readied him for entering the requisite trance state. He then comes out, deeply immersed in the character induced by the mask. More than 30 masks are recognized by the audiences of Bali. The Balinese mask had its origin in Java, where the mask, as well as the dance, was very formal and stylized. In Bali, dance and mask took on life and became expressive of this exuberant culture. The Balinese say that the mask should clearly reveal the emotions and even the facial expressions of the dancers, though the face remains hidden from view.